Hello everyone, welcome back. It's been a while since I've last been on YouTube making videos, so I'm back with a vengeance. And the new vengeance is tarantula feeding video 115. Yeah, it's been a while since I last seen a new feeding video, right? So it's time to feed all those spiders I recently got, namely the Sicarius terosus, the six-eyed sand spider, the Greek ladybird spider, the Rosus vulcanari red form. So yeah, pretty awesome. So this time we're going to go in alphabetical order and see which ones we'll eat. I can't wait. Hopefully this will be a good feeding video, like it's always been. Okay, let's get started with my Acanthus guria brocklehursti, the giant white banded. And here she is. Big old 7-inch girl. Excellent. As well, it's pretty good idea to film them in alphabetical order, so that way you'll get to see which ones I own and which ones I don't have. Over here is my male Acanthus guria geniculata, the Brazilian giant white knee. As typical for Acanthus guria's very hungry eaters. Hopefully he might mature next molt and send him over to TC so they can do a breeding project. Here's Chelsea, my female Acanthus guria suina, the sulfur brown bird eater. Usually a good eater. Come on, Chels. That's my girl. Here's Mommy Annabelle, my avic female that gave me 100 babies. Good girl, sweetheart. I bet she was hungry. Yeah, as you can tell. Yeah, she's doing well. Yeah, lovely pink toe. And, of course, you can tell that my guinea pigs are hungry. You're going to wait your turn towards the end. Ooh, I can tell that she's waiting and eager to eat. So this is my Vicularia leita, Puerto Rican pink toe, Molly. Bing! There we go. Instantaneous. Definitely has wrapped up her enclosure. And this is probably about as big as they're going to get. They're not an entirely big avic. And none that I recommend handling. This is actually one of my more meaner ones next to my versicolor. But she's good. She's doing very well. It's one of my few avics that I've managed to keep successfully. So hopefully I'll do some good on those avic avics. This is definitely one of my larger avics. This is an Avicularia urticans, giant Peru pinto. Oh, she is hungry. She is hungry. Okay, she missed that. Come for her. Come on, sweetie. Good girl. Good girl. Impressive beauty. And this is my last avic. Looks very pretty. Vicularia versicolor. This is the Antilles pinto. 3.5-inch female named Trinity. I bought this one from Shinerock 777 about 4 years ago. She's doing well in captivity, but as you can see, she's not the friendly. Not a very friendly avic. So. No, she doesn't want. But she has very impressive colors if you
notice what an avicularia versicolor looks like. Yeah. The old Lake Tetra. That's what was my original one.
Stacy's mom's got it going on. Oops, I'm sorry. I'm actually singing, Stacy. Yeah, this is my Brachypalma albiceps female, Mexican gold red rub. So let's see if she's got it going on. Sometimes it's not the greatest eater of mine, but... Oh. She just lied to me. Isn't she all pretty? Wait to see my other one. He molted. Alright, so as predicted, remember I showed you in an older video that Alberto, my other albiceps, believed to be male, was in pre-molt? Well, I think a couple of days later... Whoop, he is freshly molted, and it's time to get this guy rehoused, so I'll be rehousing him tomorrow. Alright. Let's see his first meals and see molted. I've actually kind of wanted to wait to include both of my albiceps in there, because they're such a pretty Brachypalma. Come on, he's gonna check it out. Yeah! Awesome! I'm happy. Cool. Here's Aragog, my female Brachypalma bulbulosum, Honduras curly hair. Juvenile female. There you are. Just love her hairs on her body. Curly Sue, my other one, she's 28 years old. Still alive and doing well. Here's Leon, my male Brachypalma erratum, the Mexican flame knee. Bammo. Yeah, you can see why they call it the Mexican flame knee, just look at their legs. Pretty much a big giveaway. Ooh, bloody. So, let's go see how his sister Claire is doing. Another impressive attack in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This one here is my crossbreed, Brachypalma Bomi cross Bumgarteni, called the Mexican Orange Beauty. So, let's see how Chimera does. Very beautiful specimen. And she displays the typical Brachypalma Bomi temperament, very skittish and very, very prone to flick urticating hair. Little juvenile Brachypalma Bomi, the Mexican fire leg. Usually the quickest eater of my bunch. Another fantastic eater. This is my Brachypalma Classy, the Mexican pink. Petunia. Now normally it would show my bee Amelia, but unfortunately Amelia passed away a couple of weeks ago. But we'll see how my infamous petunia does. Pretty rare tea. Could be in pre-molt. She could be due. Oh god, Athena's so pretty when she molts. Alright, so this is my female Brachypalma Smithy, Mexican Red Knee. This is the one that piqued my interest in tarantulas. Ah, it's the first time I see her knead that quick. Yeah, she's almost around five and a half inches. Just a little shy of 6 inches, which is her full length. Now let's go to my mascot of my channel, Scarlet. Alright, here's Scarlet, my other bee smithy. A very good eater. Don't think she sees it. Oh! Another healthy one. Last molted in 2013. It's around 5.5, 6 inches. Almost the same size as Athena. Ah, here's a little update on one of my freebie bee wagons that I recently got from Tarantula Canada. I can tell that this one recently molted. Looks to be about a half an inch right now, so I could start feeding a little larger crickets, but it's at least smaller than the tea itself, so. Since she's all pretty white from her molt, I'm probably not going to feed her. But that's one of my four that I recently have. Here's my second bee wagons over here. I'm not sure if he's going to eat or not, but we'll try. So I'm using little pinheads. These are like 2 weeks old. So that's how I feed little small spiderlings like that. And that's how I fed the Avic Avix. Nether wagons. Yeah, definitely a very skittish Brachypalma, and one that I don't really recommend for handling. Yeah, she's the type of that runs and goes, so. And this is the largest one that I have. This is the last wagons I have, named Morticia. This is an adult female, around 7 inches. And this is what my little small sling that I originally showed you will grow up to when she's an adult. Give or take 5 or 6 years. And the last brachies I have here are my pair of female Brachypalma verdesi, the Mexican rose gray. So this is Dr. Cossack. You see, very healthy girl. And here's Galinka. Another Fast and the Furious type. Ugh, bloody. Hate to be that super worm. Here's Zhulin, my female. Haunted enclosure, by the way. Chilobrachys guanaciensis, the Chinese fawn. Ooh, okay. That scared the pants out of me. Lucky she isn't that crazy compared to my S. calceatum, but yeah. That scared my little shaky boots. Here's Mystery, my Scythracanthus livingstoni, the Livingston's tea. Nice, really pretty tarantula. Did quite well. Here's another molt I recently got from my Crotophilus ramsey, the Cuban pygmy. I want to show you how fast this growing this species really is. So if you understand, I got this one back in 2012. It was about, you know, 3/4 of an inch, right? Well, 2 short years, guess what?
Can't believe he hooked out already. Mature male. Critophilus Ramsey. Oh my god, he's actually nice looking, and I thought for sure that he would have been a female.
Well, I guess it's custom since his scientific name is Critophilus Ramsey. I think Gordon Ramsey will be a perfect name for him. So, he recently molted, so I'm not going to be feeding him. But wow, so quickly. So that means, going to bring him to TC to breed him. Alright, well, a little bit of a disappointment. I was going to feed this one. This is my Cupunius Soleil, which is my American wandering spider that I got 2 weeks ago. Yeah, until I realized that she just recently molted. And I think it was probably fresh, like last night. Oh, wow, she looks really nice. Oh, there's the eye arrangement of the wandering spider. Now, these guys are not even dangerous at all. They're not potent as the so-called Funitra ferra, which is the most venomous spider in the world. I was going to say tarantula, but it's not. So, yeah, I guess another week before I film this gal. Actually, really nice size, too. Got this one for about 30 bucks at TC. Yeah, so give her a couple of days and then I'll record a special video on HD for you guys. Show it to you. Alright, I think someone on YouTube asked me if I had one of these guys. This is a Daemon Diadema, which is a tailless whip scorpion. This is my adult female named Dinah. So we'll see how my girl is going to eat. I've got the second cricket. Alright, let's put it in there. Ooh, lovely! That was amazing! It was lovely to see it. Got a little British accent there. Cool. Yeah, these are non-venomous arachnids, so like scorpions, they'll chew their foods with their mandibles from their chloroceria. You can just see. So now they're just going to go and slurp it up. So they're pretty safe to handle, except they're kind of on the fast side, so you've got to be careful with them. But very, very nice species to own, and they do well in your typical arboreal setup. Alright, now for my Ephippopus murranus, the skeleton tea. Yeah, cricket's gone. Hey, fellas! Here's Cleveland, my Ephippopus rufescens. This is the burgundy skeleton. This one I believe to be a male. Yeah, he never, ever, ever, ever refuses food unless he's in pre-molt. Another good eater with along with my murranus. Alright, this is my Erysus walkenari. This is my Greek ladybird spider. Unsexed. It's about 1/3 of an inch. So these are really hungry spiders when they get older. I know she really wants to have it. She's hiding in her cocoon. They built the most immaculate webs that I have ever seen on a true spider.
So yeah, this is what you should be feeding little small spiders. But I guess, not interested, but I guess we got a good glimpse of her to see what she actually looks like up close and personal. She's going to get like 2-3 inches, so very good one. Ah, everyone remembers Amber. She is my Euathlus species red, Chilean fire rump. Definitely the most docile tarantula that I've personally cared for. And of course, for some reason she seems to enjoy handling. Very reluctant to go back into her hide, but very beautiful species. Alright, this one here is my Eucratocellus pachypus. Stout-legged baboon. This is a female. I haven't named her yet, so I think I might call her Eileen. Oh, lovely! Yeah! I just love how my teas eat like that. It's so funny. Impressive colors, and one of the more docile baboons, so this will be a perfect starter old world tarantula. Here's Yasmin, my Eupalustris camperstratus, the pink zebra beauty. Yeah, with a piece of old malt stuck with her. 4.5 inch female. My little Eupalustris wagenbergi, the white collared. What a fearless tea. Alrighty now for some Gramostolas. Now this is a male Gramostola pulchra, Brazilian black. One of the larger ones. Well, this guy's a little male named Roy, so you gotta see the girl, Ebony. She's like huge. It's like almost double his size. Ah, there we go. What a good boy. And he'll be my future mating project with her. Yeah, they're good eaters. Here we go. Here's Ebony. This is my mature female. Let's see if I can try to get some fang action going on. Ah, there we go. You see that? These are like huge fangs. Roughly about 3/4 to about 1 inch long. Yeah. Pretty scary for a docile species. Well, pulchras, to me, in my opinion, are a little bit unpredictable. Sometimes they'll be docile 1 minute and then moody the next, just like your Rosea. But I do suggest getting one of these ones. These are one of the more pretty tarantulas, especially since it's one of the more black ones in the hobby. It's perhaps the blackest one. And Ebony is a name that really, really suits her well. Probably predicted, the next one is Gramostola pulchropes, the Chaco goldeni. I have 3 females, so I'm likely going to feature all of them. So this is Peach, my 4.5 inch female. This is her sis, Wendy. Ah, yeah, definitely some defensive behavior there. She could be due for a molt. That's entirely possible since, Last molted 2011, 2012? I believe so, yeah. Alright, now let's try Charlotte, the big bad one.
She feels like she's the queen of the mountain. Alright, let's go fix up a juicy super for her. Oh! There we go, totally. Big bad wolf.
Alright, this one is Morris Rose. My male, Gramostola rosea red phase. Had him for 5 years as a half an inch spiraling, and you can see this is probably the rosea that really eats the most and the most good eater out of my collection of four of them. And I just fed Lois the female red phase and she wasn't interested in eating, so we'll try my normal forms and we'll see if those are going to do well as he did right now.
This is Michaela, my normal form rose here. Didn't eat last time. So let's see what she's going to do this time. Nothing.
This is my Haplopalma abostriatum. Hey, not bad. This is the Ratchaburi, which is the Thailand zebra dark form. Sweet. Love it. Here's a Haplopalma lividum, cobalt blue. And I think that cricket is dead. Yep, you can see the legs right over here. She got it. Kina, my Haplopus species Columbia large, the pumpkin patch. Now I can tell that she's hungry. Beautiful spider. I can see very skittish too. Abby, my Holothele Incy, Trinidad Olive. Has an elaborate system of many, many holes. And as I told you in Mythbuster video 47, one of the best communal species by far. Super fantastic eater. This part is for Rose. She asked me if I had a Hystericrates gigas, the Cameroon red baboon, and sure enough I do. It's a big female that you see way down below. It's around 4-5 inches. I got it from Angelo for about $50. This is Jasmine. She is my Lampropalma phalaseopes, which is a Singapore violet or blue. She's so swift, it's unbelievable. Quick was like, help me! Help me! No! Yeah, I'm kind of mean. But it's the life cycle and he's gotta eat, you know? Now for some Lasiodoras. This one here is my big L. difficilis, the Brazilian fire red bird eater. It's usually the first tarantula that I feature in the feeding videos. 7-inch girl named Dora. Recently just regenerated her missing pulp, although it's not really perfect yet, so by next mulch she'll have it completely.
El Fracta.
Oh gee, Willow. Oh my god, have you grown, girl? Oh wow. Alright, let's see how fresh that molt is. I can tell by her fangs. As you probably can see, they're white. So usually when you have freshly molted teas like that, it's best to give them about a week or two to settle in before you do anything. So right now I'm just going to leave her alone, and then by next week I'll be upgrading her into a bigger enclosure. I think this is a little bit too small for her now. Wow, considering she was about 3 inches, now she looks to be around the 3.5 to 4. Gotta love these Lassiodoras, how fast they grow. It's amazing. My Kluge will be going where she used to be. This is Necroth. I got that name from Unreal Tournament. When I play my Dreamcast. And yeah, he got him. Oh no.
Maybe not yet.
Here we go. He's such a gentle grabber. But wait till you see my power habana. You can see how vicious they are when they're eating. This one here is my Lassiodora power habana, salmon pink bird eater. So you'll see all three of my females. This is Daniela. You can see he's so much more vicious than my Kluge that you just seen. She's around 6 years old. Right now we'll try Goma, my little smaller one. Here she is. Superb. Here's Daisy. As you can see, very ferocious eaters. And that's pretty much all the Lassiodoras that I have now. Next one up is my Megaphobema robustum, Colombian giant red leg. See how this one's gonna eat. Very beautiful species that gets up to having an 8-inch leg span. There you have it. This is my Nandu chromatis, the white striped bird eater. 4.5-inch female named Nadia. Another fast food junkie. Loves to run and go. Yeah, she's very healthy. This is Mina, my Nandu Colorado velosus, the Brazilian black and white. Awesome. Alright, close the cage because this is the tarantula that gives me really bad hives when I react to their irritating hair. So, yeah, not fun. I'm already itching right now. Here's everyone's favorite Nandu. This is Darius, my tripepi, or giant strawberry blonde bird eater, or giant blonde bird eater. Which ones you prefer?
Doesn't really matter. Alright,
Darius is, I named him after a Mortal Kombat character, because he has some sick moves. So let's see if he's going to display them for us on camera. He usually does. Alright, Darius. Good boy. Yeah, 3 for 3 for my Nandus. Awesome. It's an Orphanaceous filipinus, which is the Filipino orange. Nimorana, which is a female name, but I have reason to believe that my specimen is a suspect male. So let's see how well he does. Oh, love it. There we go, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, deep burrower, moist substrate, and they do extremely well.
This is arguably the largest tarantula that I have in my collection. This is a Pamphibidius species chicken spider, commonly called the chicken-eating spider, from Peru. Now I named her Shelob after Lord of the Rings, the big spider demon. So it's amazing that she's really not eating very well compared to my other Pamphibidius that are savages. Oh well, give you an update on her.
I missed the attack of this one. This is my Pamphibidius species Platyama, the pink bloom bird eater. Yeah, there's Maggie barking in the background. Gotta see who that is. Pamphibidius ultramarinus, the Ecuadorian purple-pink femur. And this one, Lauren. Wow. Pretty quick. One of my favorite Pamphibidius species.
Let's see if this little girl is interested. This is my Phoedopus regius, the regal jumping spider. Trying to... down a little bit so you can see the cricket below. I don't know if she's going to see it. Ooh, nice! That was a spectacular jump, little missy. Awesome! Aren't these jumping spiders the cutest little critters? The Iron Ancients are so cute. Love it.
Spawn from hell! Okay, this is a Formictopus cancerides, Asian brown bird eater. Spawns from hell because there are evil. Yeah, this is Big Jezebel. Around a 7-inch specimen. Brought from a pet store, no doubt. So I know this is a wild caught, unfortunately. Yeah. Get some fang action going on.
Isabella, I should give a more menacing laugh. You can see right quick reflexes from her. And she freshly molted, so you can see her colors are much more vibrant than my other one. Here's Holly, Formictopus platus, the Caribbean island bird eater. Almost instantaneously. Wow. Like I said, these Formictopus, Canthoscurias, and Lasiodoras are fearless eaters. Amazing. For one of my favorite genus in the tarantula hobby, the Poplotheria species. So here is my very favorite tarantula of mine. This is a Poplotheria barra, ivory lowland ornamental. Ooh, nice. Crunch. Here's my P. formosa, Salem ornamental. Yeah, this is Salem. A 7-inch female. This is my recently acquired Poplotheria hanuma vila samica. This is the Rameshwar ornamental. It's about an inch and a half. Young juvenile specimen.
Oh, oh. She wants it.
Oh, lovey.
Eventual sex. I'm thinking this guy might be a male. Not quite sure. A little bit too young.
But he did a good job.
Safina, my other Hanamabula Samika.
Super. I'm hoping the pair that I just have is a male and female. This one's about 3 years old. Back then I paid for this one $215. Now considering the one I just bought, I only paid $65 for it. Goes to show you how Hanamabula Samikas now sure have gone down in price.
Alright, way down below. Not sure if you can actually make out the legs. Is my female P. Metallica Goody Sapphire Ornamental. Little Mia. And as people are wondering what happened to my little girl, well, there she is. She's very skittish. Let's see, she loves to hide behind the enclosure. Look at her, she's so camera shy. It's so hilarious. Yeah. Yeah, you can make out the blue legs. Yeah, she's alive and well. I'm expecting her to molt anytime soon now. She's been about a year and a half right now that she last molted, so it could explain why she hasn't been eating recently, but there's an update for everyone who's interested in knowing if my P. Metallica is still with me. Here's Okami, my 8-inch female P. Ornata, fringed ornamental. Ooh, whoopee. See, it's always a good idea to have tongs, as you never know what can happen. Alright, so that was a bust. Let's take another one. There we go. Successful. This is my second and only crossbreed that I have. This is a Poclotheria ornata cross vitata. Some type of ornamental, fringed ghost, I would say. Here's Big Allison, Poclotheria smithii, the yellow-backed ornamental. Not sure she's hungry, but we'll see. There we go. Yep. I'm proud of this one. First try buying one and ends up being female. Totally sweet. Alright, this is a mature male, Poclotheria striata, the Mysore ornamental. You can see he doesn't really look like a pokey because he lost all his coloration. Ooh, nice guy. As you can see, here's Dom. Now we'll compare with a female. And here is Marie, one of my females. She's really... Ah, she got it. Nice. Yeah, this is a female, and you can really tell the differences between the male. See how colorful she is versus
the mail, which is over here. He's a dark brown color versus the gray colors in the females. That's how you tell if your Pokey is mature or not. But both superb eaters, I'm surprised, because usually my pair would never eat. And cool, I'm happy. So now I'm about 4 hours in and still a couple more teas left to finish.
And this is my Striata sling. So maybe we'll go 3 for 3.
I don't believe it. 3 for 3. Sweet. I'm loving this so far. Good feeding video.
This is my Pocotheria saphusca highland. The candy highland ornamental.
Wow. Surprise, surprise, she got it. Alright, this is a Pocotheria vitata, formerly known as Petrosenni ghost ornamental. 7-inch female. Oh. There we go.
Here's a 7-inch female Somopolis camergi, Trinidad Chevron.
That's a lovely girl.
Somopolis Herminia, the Venezuelan Sun Tiger.
Yeah.
And that one ain't no problem. And I have a little slightly larger one. And that's not very hungry. Alright, Sicarius terosus, the six-eyed sand spider.
Yes, this is the second most venomous spider in the world. I will be doing a Mythbuster video on this one. This will be number 50. The venom is really strong. And supposedly, it's about 20 times stronger than that of a brown recluse. Takes some serious guts to own a species of this caliber. But it's cool that it ate on camera. Here's a Tapenakinius elleni, the gold tree spider. Do you believe that she got it? Yes, sir. Awesome. Here's my tea latte peeps. Huh? Offered a cricket and she could get it. She did molt. You can see there's a piece of molt here. About an inch. Tapenakinius gigas, the orange tree spider. This is Barb, 4-inch female. Perfect. This is the second largest tea in my collection. A big Theraphosa sturmi.
Ooh.
Burgundy Goliath bird eater. I can tell she wasn't happy. Yeah, she's just hungry. Very, very hungry. There we go. She got the first one. Now let's see if she's gonna get the second one.
And there we go. Some fang action. And I can tell that this is not a real T. Blondie. See where the patella hair are? Which is basically the knees. Which is over here. And a real Blondie would have a bunch of hair in there. So since this one is bald, this is the true T. Sturmi. But there's not really any difference compared to a T. Blondie and T. Sturmi. They're both equally identical. And they're just equally as beautiful. Here's a Thrixopelma sanulum, the cobalt red rump. A marin, 1.5 inches, possible female. Very good. The Viridaceous species Madagascar, the Madagascar fishing spider. Recently did a Mythbuster video about 2 weeks ago. And this is a female. Surprised, not hungry. Usually eats. Here's a Vitellius paraniniensis. Brazilian brown bird eater. And I can tell that she's very hungry. She just bit the tongs. Come on, I know you're hungry. That's my girl. And of course, here's the video of Maggie, my 9-year-old female Shih Tzu. Can't believe next week she's going to be 10 years old. Okay, roll over. Come on. There we go. Sit. Paw. Come on, paw. Paw. Shh. Look how full of energy she is. Paw. Other paw. Dance. Come on. There we go. High five. There we go. Good girl. Good girl. Of course, we don't forget my furries. So this is my Russian dwarf hamster, Naya. Isn't she cute? Come on, little munchkin. Gretel will certainly love her, but I would never feed my hamster to my tarantula. There is no way. There's no way she's completely safe. Aren't you hungry? No? You sure? Want to say hi to the camera? You're so pretty. You're so pretty. You gotta love your hamsters. It's too bad that they don't really live that long in captivity for about 1.5 years and they unfortunately pass away. And of course, my 2 guinea pigs. This is Leah, my female Abyssinian guinea pig that was born on October 10th of 2012. And here's Haley. Got her in September of 2012. She was a bundle of joy back then and still is a bundle of joy now. Both of them are very friendly. They like to be handled. Well, with the exception of Leah. Leah's a little bit on the nervous side, but
In most cases with Abyssinian guinea pigs, they can be a little bit skittish. Haley's not even skittish at all. She's very, very friendly. You could rub her, stroke her, and she loves it.
Alright, everyone. So, it is currently 1:04 on the 4th of May. So, may the 4th be with you. So I do hope you enjoyed this awesome feeding video. I think this was the most diverse one that I've done yet. And you got at least a good 75 to 80 inverts that I've shown. It's too bad that my centipedes wasn't featured in the feeding video, so hopefully I'll get it next time. So enjoy, everyone, and stay tuned for the feeding video. I'm going to upload it tomorrow.